Very good morning. Today I am uploading this video over using my Excel utility to upload data under the bulk upload system. So the drawback is we can upload up to 100 records or maximum 25 MB batch file size in for a single upload. So there is another provision provided by CKYC that is called SFTP. So you can through SFTP you can upload tremendous data. So I will show you how to do the request to CKYC and how to upload the data. Okay, so what is SFTP? You can upload data without any limitation. That means 5,000 records, 10,000 records, whatever. But depends on you. That is totally depends on your internet speed. So I prefer at least because what in between if that link breaks, then you have to upload the data again. So that will be a burden. So better to upload 1,000 records each. So the maximum size for one record should be 350 KB. So for 1,000 records, the total file size should be approx 350 MB. So what is the drawback? Because the bulk upload, you can upload data from anywhere with both DSCs. That is the criteria for bulk upload. But in this SFTP, the very first thing you have to upload, I mean you have to you have to whitelist your IP address, and from that IP address only you can upload the data. So the maximum IPs they are providing 10. Okay, so once you uplist that 10 IPs, from that only you can upload the data. Okay, so how to get SFTP approval? So open your browser, just type in the Google my IP address, so that your IP address will be shown over there, 111 point something like that. So that is your IP address. So there is a request form also that I attach it in the description box, and you can download it from the CKYC portal also. So in that there are two columns. One is test bid SFTP and another is the production SFTP. If you are already uploading data in the productions, then you don't take SFTP for the test bid. You can go live directly. So I will show you how to fill the form and everything. So this is the format. This is the format which should be taken in your letterhead. That is the first thing. And here you can see the name. Name they have mentioned that input. Here I have mentioned inputter name. So who are your inputter name? That name should be mentioned here. And below you can see user ID. So suppose in this case you are here, you can see test bid and production here. So in case you are taking you are whitelisting your IP for test bid and production, you have to write that IP address in both places. Otherwise, in case you are only taking the only whitelisting your IP, then you have to write it in the production only. In case you are writing IP for in both sides, then you have to mention your user IDs, test bid IP address first, then a comma, then your production IP address. In case you are writing only production IP address only in the production column, then you have to mention only the production IP address here. This is your registered email ID. Registered email ID in the sense that nodal officer's email ID. From that you have to send the mail, and this is the mobile number of that person. Okay, then take approval, take sign, stamp, and send that scan copy to helpdesk@ckycindia.in. Okay, so once you upload, after 4 working days, they will send you a mail confirmation. And like you can see a link here, see. So in you click on this link, then a new window will be opened, which will ask you the user ID and password of the existing inputter. So you have to type that user ID and password, and there is a button to OK. Click OK. So once you click OK, your SFTP whitelisting will be activated. After that, there is a free software available that is called FileZilla that you can download it for free. So you just download and install it. It's a 9 MB file. Once you open that, once install and open that software, it will show like this. With here you can see a host name, user ID, and password, and a port. So these details you will get it in the email. What is your so technically this is nothing, but in case you have, you are uploading data in the production, so the host IP should be, host address should be uploads.ckyc.india.in, and the username is the input username, and password is the same input password, inputter password. Here you have to do the port 22 and click on the Quick Connect. If everything is fine, you can see in the left hand side two folders. One is input folder and another is the response folder. Also, you can see the status here, like directory listing is successful. So once you get this window, you should click on the input folder first. Once you click on the input folder, again you can see the status here, input directory listing successful. After that, I am recording this video because you have, or you are already using my Excel utility. So once you run that Excel utility, one zip file will be generated. Like suppose this is the 45th batch zip file. So in the same folder, you create a notepad. In right button, new file, new text file. Then you can see new text document .txt, whatever. So what you have to do, copy this name as it is and rename this notepad. With the .trg extension, that's all. So normally a notepad should be what? This name .txt. So you have to remove everything including that txt and change the name to the same batch file .trg. This is nothing, but it's a requirement from their side. And you have to drag and drop both files. You can see that zip file is here and that trg notepad is here. It's a blank notepad, nothing is there in this notepad, and you drag and drop both files into this folder in this panel. So automatically that program will execute and will upload the data. Once upload the data, after 2-3 minutes, it depends on your file size, you just click on this response folder. So if that file is already processed, you will get a notepad in the same name. That means what is the status and everything, you will get it over here in this notepad. So in the left hand side you can see your home directory, like in your computer directory. So click on whichever the folder you want to download this notepad. Here in the right hand side, click on this notepad and click on the download button. That notepad will be downloaded, and you can see in this case for testing I have uploaded two records, and I can see the reference number also here. Like the, in case if there is an error, then you have to rectify it and upload it again. So once you got this information, like you have successfully inserted the data, then you have to approve it with the approver DOC, which you know very well. So just again log into this website, type your user ID and password, select your DSC, and you will get this new window. And again click on this under KYC management bulk upload authorization, the same way how we authorize the bulk upload. And once you authorize after 2-3 minutes or after some time depends on your file size, click on this bulk upload response. Here you can see the response in case that file is executed, you can see this remarks here. Uploaded successfully. In case it's not processed yet, so you can see the messages under process. Here it is already uploaded successfully. If it's failed, then you have to check that notepad and upload the data again in that SFTP. Here it's already mentioned that uploaded successfully. You can see the response by clicking this what we call it. Here it's a text, you have just to click that in a notepad will be downloaded. Open that, so you can see that your data is uploaded successfully. Okay, after 2 days that KYC will be generated, that should be in the logs and reports, or I think here or here in the MIS management you can see the what we called the CKYC number, 16 digit CKYC number. Okay, this is the procedure to take approval for the SFTP. In case any help, you can mail me. This is my email ID, subbvg@gmail.com. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.